Pope was very keen to drop and run yesterday, as well as the aggressive strokes to the boundary. Just quickly onto that, Ollie Pope. And that's a fine shot, kept it under control. And it's going to go away for four byes, I think. No, four runs it's been given out.
High quality, and the line of Rabada counts for Pope. It was in that channel again.
Yeah, success for Kajisa Rabada. Coming down slightly hooded from Ollie Pope. Oh, he's nailed that. And difficult bowling to a moving target. Oh, got him. Got him. It was pretty anticlimactic in the end. Stuart Broad, for the first time, not really following through with the stroke. It was an excellent piece of bowl.
Yeah, beautifully bowled. We were talking a little while ago about the slow ball and the change of pace, especially when the batters swing.
Trickle away. South Africa's fielding has had its moments this morning. Wide though, and Leach is happy to put back to ball. Nice shot. Not really a long half volley, but beautifully timed by Leach through extra cover.
Got him this time. That off stump just flattened by Marco Janssen, so Leach's innings is done in the most spectacular fashion.
It was a bit fuller, it was tighter into off stump, enticed to drive, a bit of seam movement, too good for Jack Leach. South Africa have been excellent this morning, England have rode their luck, but...
Given him! And that is five for Kagiso Rabada. And he has absolutely deserved that. He has bowled superbly from the moment that he took up. This was the conclusion to it all, with Anderson getting too far across and a bit of late in-swing from Rabada. An absolute delight for him.
Yeah, tough as teak.
That's a lovely drive. You're hitting it straight through mid-on as a left-hander. Clipped away. That's a comfortable boundary to get the account of Ervier up and running.
And it's cut him in half. Is it the first of the day? It is for Stuart Broad. His first, but also his 100th at Lord's.
Pitching line, impact in line, wickets missing, we'll go back to early on field. Signal now.
Change of attack, and it's through the hands, it bursts through very quickly, so much so, it'll find the boundary line.
Outside his crease as he faces up, negates movement and finds the fence square. Poor shot. That sounded gorgeous off the bat and flies away to the mid-wicket fence. Your guy will just be over my dead body, won't he? Oh, in the air once again. He'll bring up another boundary. Oh, that's going to be another boundary. Stokes will sprint after it, but that's going to be a sprint in vain. Short wide and cut away up the hill. Just creep into the boundary cushions. And that is a beauty.
That one is also timed nicely through the onside, down the slope. And into the boundary. It's a nice punch off the back foot. It's got a bit of work to do up the hill, but the timing is up to it.
Yeah.
Yep, that's through as well. More work to do up the hill. And it might not get there. Or does it? No. Potentially drag back another. Ball onto the stumps. He cannot believe it. Dean Elgar. Thought he had it covered. Watched it as it trailed on. Couldn't get a boot to it. Couldn't get a bat to it. And the opening partnership comes to an end.
Off the thigh pad. This often just goes off the leg, arm. And that horrible slow death where you can see it in slow motion and there's absolutely nothing you can do about it. That is devastating for Dean Elgar.
Another one that tails in. That's the kind of way you'd like to dream about getting off the mark at Lord's, finding the middle of the bat. Finds the thick outside edge. And yet again, the England players after it. And yet again, the ball wins.
Well, it's off the outside edge and it's slightly aerial, but it's safe. And it's four.
Driven safely, driven square, driven for four. And that is 50 for Ervier.
Every now and again.
Half volley and dealt with in no uncertain terms by Peterson. Edged and gone. Johnny Bairstow.
Missing on a number of occasions. And then he kept hammering that spot. Hopeful in his attempt that he'd find that outside edge. Yes, Johnny Bairstow, you took the catch. Pope pretty happy with it as well.
Well, that's a good example of a cover drive from Aidan Markram. If we were looking at a glitch. Lovely, real flourish from Markram. Looked like an attempted in-swinger from Anderson. He was pushing it on a full driving length to find that swing, but...
Go.
Well... For a moment, I just thought he was going to pick up a couple here. I thought Lees will cut this off because he just seemed to play it with such ease, but...
Ah!
And again, Leach. Yeah, this is beautiful bowling from Jack Leach. He looked dangerous before tee, was given two overs by Ben Stokes' outside edge. Excellent.
Excellent dip and turn, but Aidan Markram won't be happy with that poke. Really indecisive in terms of how he played that.
Go.
Finds the gap. It was a little shorter this time from Leach. Van der Dussen had time, picked his spot, gets off the mark. .com, lots of great prizes. Oh, inside edge, close to off stump. Stokes replacing Anderson at the pavilion end and almost too good for Van der Dussen with his first ball.
If that's just the moisture.
Go!
Yeah, and that bounce just may bring a top edge. You've already seen.
Catch.
And again, and it's the sweep shot he's looking for because that area is vacant and he brings up four. Ooh, that's a brute. Folks, gone. The plan has worked, and that is fantastic from England's captain.
It was absolutely bang on. What could he have done here? Tried to rise with the ball, it was off the gloves. All he could do was stand and watch as it fell into the hands of Folks. Took a while for the crowd. Yeah, that's your wicket. Get up. Fingers up.
He's going to take it on, and deep square leg hasn't seen that at all. Maybe Stokes has done it again. A change of plan, a more orthodox route, and it has brought the wicket of Rassi van der Dussen. More orthodox now to van der Dussen with a bit of a scrambled seam. Ball nipping down the slope. And he is leading the fight back. 192 for five. South Africa's lead is just 27. And van der Dussen is out for 19.
It's not the sort of short ball strategy you're looking for from your left-arm spinner. Got him. Oh, that's a beauty. 100th wicket at Lord's for Stuart Broad. And it's an absolute ripper.
Now, know that they've got a great opportunity here, not just to take the rest of the wickets, but to set this game up. They've been disciplined. They've been good.
And it's edged straight past Johnny Bairstow at third slip. Don't think it was catchable height. Flashed away, and that will race away down the hill for four.
Punch off the back foot. Still on the way up the ball too, but he's got that extra height, does Jansen, and it's one of those awful little teasers that says, now you got to come and get me. Hands went from low to high, and for a moment Jansen was thinking, get there, get there, but it clears it comfortably. Backs into it and gets him. Potts with the catch, Stokes with the wicket. No, let's just sway underneath that delivery from Ben Stokes.